Welcome aboard, everybody. We got a special treat for you today. We are in the Velocity XL, and this has been a childhood dream of mine to actually own one of these aircrafts and build one. And today, we get to bring you along on a great little flight. All right, so what's all over the news? You got SpaceX, you got Blue Origin, you have NASA, but everyone's forgotten about the original spaceship, right? What's the original spaceship? Well, if you're a pilot, the original spaceship is the Velocity, which is behind me. So in the 90s, when I was getting my pilot's license, all over the magazines, all over everything, was this amazing aircraft right here that looked just like a spaceship. And when people would see it flying, they thought it's a spaceship in the air. Well, today, we get to check out the Velocity XL.
All right, Sebastian Traffic, Spremel 916, Tango Charlie, departing runway 10, Sebastian B, left turnout for noise.
Yeah, you'll feel the turbo, but again, we're only gonna go to 35 inches or so. But still feel it when it gets past 29. To readjust that. I'll get to about 70, pull the stick back, kind of a tug, and then do this.
Sebastian,
see how the back end a little bit.
426 established,
here's coming up.
Wind, runway 10, Sebastian.
Nice crosswind, and then noise abatement. I'll leave everything up for just a little bit to show you the climb rate when you're, there's my climb rate there. Usually about 1800 to 2000 stabilized as she climbs. Then I just pull it back. And normally I run this one at 27 inches and 2300 RPM. So back quite a ways on the throttle on the and the prop.
Right.
It's much quieter to run the prop at 2300 RPM.
Even on climb, you'll bring it down to 2300?
2623, yeah.
Wow.
All the way up.
So the velocity was I remember as a young man, you know, reading up on it, I mean, it was, it's known as the spaceship airplane. People would see it and be like, what
yeah,
is that?
Really
looks,
cool.
Looks
yep.
like a spaceship. And it's just kind of seems to have never lost that mystique about it, even though, I mean, obviously over the years, there's so many of these now flying,
yep.
and because it's such a great design and such a great airplane.
All right, so what is the Velocity? Well, for those who don't know, the Velocity is an experimental aircraft. It's a canard design with this big swept wing in the back. What's the advantages and disadvantages? Disadvantages, probably none that I really know of. Advantages, well, they're countless. So for starters, the biggest advantage to this canard design is simply that the canard wing will stall before the main wing does. So what does that mean? It means that when you're in flight, you would, if you're climbing too steeply and the wings no longer produce lift, this canard will actually stall before the wing stalls. So what's the Velocity capable of? It's actually capable of climbing in a stall.
Anyway, we just pull it up, and then you'll see it, and I'm not sure which one's correct. They're both about 5-6 minutes off. That's the nose bob.
Yep.
That's what you get. So that's all you're
going
to get. So, and it's feet on the floor, so
right.
the ball doesn't hardly move.
Right.
And as soon as I let go of it, I don't know what I tripped to, but whatever it is, you'll see it come back to that. And it'll climb in the pitch buck with power on. It's just about 200 to 300 feet per minute less
right.
than it does when the power's off. Or
yeah.
without the pitch buck.
Right. Yeah, I remember, like I said, as a kid, I've always been following Velocity and the airplanes and always been in love with them. And I remember being just in awe over the fact that that the canard stalls first and it can actually just sit there and bob and,
yep.
and
That's
not,
it,
it doesn't stall, it doesn't go anywhere, it can even climb.
Right.
And
it doesn't roll off to the side.
Yeah, I was always like, to me, that's the most amazing thing.
So one of the most recognized features of the Velocity is actually the winglets that are on the single engine version. But when you get to the V-twin, due to its design, it's actually only a fraction of the size.
Let me show you some roll coupling. I'll go through a pretty quick job of this. Right rudder
you get roll coupling in there. See, if I just move a little bit, it's just going to roll the plane to the right.
Right.
And if I let my feet off, anything above about 100 knots, it's pretty neutral in roll, so we'll just stay there in a circle.
Nice.
And here's rudder, left rudder going back. If I hit it hard enough, it will yaw the plane a little bit first, but it almost does a better roll than the ailerons do. Now watch, we don't have a horizon that way. Let me go turn back to the north. Kind of a hazy day today, you can't see. But anyway, we'll turn around to the north and I'll do it with no rudder and I'll do it with rudder. And I'll show you at slow speeds when you're coming into land, how you need to deal with crosswind, bumpy weather, bumpy air, stuff like that. So we'll kind of at least not get it too steep here. So if I try to go right, feet on the floor, see the nose wander off?
Right.
Nose wanders off,
adverse
yaw.
Yep.
So to stop that, I just go rudder, 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 and I do quite a bit of it just before the aileron comes in. So it keeps right. That nose not right where I want it. But if you just sort of ease in on it, it doesn't do much. Yeah, it's just sort of, because it's just a drag producer. And then the more reflex you have in your winglets when you build them, the quicker they are. So these are a little slow, but they're not bad. And also, turns around a point. I mean, I can bank pretty turn around a point, and it just doesn't seem to get, pushed into the seat as much as I do a conventional design.
Right.
And really, physics says otherwise, but it still feels that way.
Established in a left downwind runway 10, fast traffic.
If I go 27-23 on the lean side, it only burns about 13 an hour, but it slows down quite a bit. But if you want economy on a long trip, go up to 17.5, go 27.23, 13 gallons an hour, doing about 205 or so like that, and you got a lot of fuel on board.
And you said this is 90 gallons?
This holds 90, yeah. About here to Oshkosh, really, about all you can, and then have comfort. It should be right around 200 at this, and then I'm about 185 at this altitude at 13 gallons an hour. But a lot of the guys with normally aspirated engines tell me on their Continentals they get 180 on 10 if they have the electronic ignition, which is pretty good. I expect more like 170 at 10 gallons an hour. And I'll just fly it around a little bit, see what you like. We have to trim it up just a little bit because I'm slowed down a little bit. But anyway, yeah, you could. This is, again, no push rods, this is cables.
Right.
So there's a little bit of breakout and a little slop and everything, you can fly it around.
Right, and so, and now.
You don't need rudders.
The newer design, as you mentioned,
it is so smooth.
It's a push rod in here versus the.
It's
cable.
Actually in the back, is where the push rods are.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, so you could play around with it. And it's just, biggest difference is that it's very smooth. It's almost like an Aerostar. You ever flown an Aerostar?
I have not.
They are beautiful flying airplanes. And it's almost like, you know, you get the feedback with the air loads on the ailerons, feedback, like you push it in, you let go, and it kind of, you feel that spring back.
Right.
Yeah, we got no horizon.
Yeah, there's zero horizon in front of me right now.
That's just an airplane up in the air, though. People are like, oh, it's a canard. Is it unstable? No. In fact, it's more stable than most that I've ever flown, conventional designs. This is really made to go places, not to play around a whole lot.
Right.
I mean, you could do wingovers, and you could do, you know, you could do rolls if you want. I mean, I've done them in here, but it's so lethargic getting around. It's not fun. It's not that fun.
Well, for me, airplane's always been about going places.
Yep.
And so hence why I own a Baron. Before I owned a Baron, I owned a Mooney.
Yep.
You know, all get their airplanes.
So we got to do, we always do on a flight, is down the beach run. So we got to do the down the beach run. You good to go? You fly your Baron to 200 feet?
We just did a trip, actually in a friend's Baron, at 500 feet, going right down. 500 is as low as he would go.
But we don't worry about corrosion. So, in fact, I don't like going below about 200 because I'm afraid of sharks jumping that high. Get me. But I've had some of the guys who flew, they go 50 feet. Now it's obviously hot down here.
It is warm. Oh, this is awesome. I feel like I'm in a boat.
Yeah, so we'll, it's a little choppy. But you can see the wings move around a little bit when we're choppy.
Yeah.
And that gets takes some of the bounciness off of the inside of the cockpit. Gotta watch out for B1RDs and GO11s. You know what those are, right?
Oh, what's that?
Birds and gulls, B1RGs and GO11s.
It's so cool.
at 200 feet. And in any airplane, though, you got to be careful doing, you know, high bank turns, low down, and all that
stuff. Of course.
Let's go ahead and we'll pull the nose up a little bit more and come back over land and head back over. So I'm long as I'm 500 feet right over land. One thing too, with this much power, I you know, if I was in the other airplane, I'd just be full throttle all the time. And
right.
This one here.
And the non-turbo version.
Yeah, or even right. even the trainer is that way because it does not overpowered.
Right.
This one seems like it has so much extra power I don't need. So when I'm in this one, I guess I don't force it as much as I could.
Right.
All right, yeah, it seems like the four-bladed propeller is a little smoother than the three. Not sure, you know, they've both been balanced, dynamically balanced.
So this one in particular, the XL, with the power settings and the 90 gallons of fuel, what's the range in this airplane?
Yeah, this is about 1,400 miles with this one. You usually get about 1,000 miles with 70 gallons, but you've got to be, you know, conscious of,
right.
You know, saving fuel, leaning, and all that stuff.
Sure.
So gear speed's 120. Gear's coming down. At this point, I will use rudder if I need it, more so than I ever would. When I'm cruising, I don't use them at all. So you get kind of complacent with rudder act. But when you see the nose wander around, push your rudder in like an injection, stops it from doing that. So the crosswind we have, I'll just leave it crabbed till we get it close, and then we'll straighten it up.
How about you?
Assuming it. My son's way better than me at this stuff, but. Hey, gears down.
All right, don't worry, nobody will see this.
Yeah, right, exactly. And my son's good enough, since he knows the plane's gonna yaw to the left when he rolls to the right, if he needs to yaw the airplane, that way he kind of moves the stick over. I'm like, I could never do that.
Now, for those who don't know, the Velocity doesn't have any flaps. So
right.
There's no flaps on us, it's just gear and power.
Exactly right. And even if I went too slow right now, the nose would just start bobbing up and down. So it's pretty much a glider. At this point, you're almost power off. So see?
You got the power all the way back?
Power's off. And if you wanted to slip, you could. So if I want to slip, I could push a rudder, just like any airplane.
Right.
And give yourself a little bit more drag there.
Now do you typically, since you're doing power off and treating it like a glider, do you typically take a steeper approach coming in?
There's just
really.
No way. There's not enough drag in here to get any kind of steeper. This is about, power off is about as steep as you can get.
Gotcha.
We're about 90. In fact, it's a little bumpy out this evening, so we'll come in a little bit faster just to be sure we're ready. It also controls much easier with a little bit of extra speed. Some B1RDs up there. Okay, so I'm coming in, my power's off. And then what you do is I'll leave it crapped here again a little closer. Okay, just gotta find that runway, and I keep that aileron over there, and then still the nose is up, and then I'll let the nose down, and then here's the brakes I talked about.
Those are definitely some good brakes. Now, what do you find is a comfortable number, runway-wise, like if you're flying, if you own the Velocity and you're flying around 2,500, is that your minimum?
I tell people 25 to 27, half-mile strips. That's 3,000 or
right.
Over 3,000.
Obviously, flying a Baron to V-twin has a special place in my heart. There's just something about that line and seeing that rotor back there that's just, can't wait to be able to fly one of these. So with 30 years of building experience, they started off with a single engine fixed gear. They went to retractable, they went to a bigger airplane. They then went to a V-twin. Velocity has never just sat around and just lived on their design. They keep pushing the envelope. And this bad boy behind me is just another example of it. This is a turbine V-twin.
Turn my open to get it cooled off. Just, yeah, there you go. You know what I didn't do? I didn't turn my headset on.
Literally what we talked about.
With a brake steering airplane, the best way to take off is to roll into it. Never, you know, park brake or brake the thing and hold it for full throttle. This is always fastest. So you're pretty light, so I could probably rotate at about 55 to 60. Let's just rotate now. The nose up. Didn't even go full throttle there. Positive rate, gear's coming. And then I'll roll to the left to get out of here. But you got, you can fly.
Oh man, I can't. I don't even know what to do.
Here, you can probably put that lever forward, that lever down there.
Okay.
Move that forward, just kind of rotate it forward. There you go.
There we go, that's better.
There you go. if you have to, trim it a little bit more because we're not going fast enough, you can trim it a little bit if you need to. There's no horizon, so you might have to look at that.
Yeah.
Or turn to the left where it's land. It's easier to see it. Yeah, it's like a little video game. I have side sticks too, designed those. And so you got side sticks, the center stick, yokes, but nobody ever uses the yokes anymore. So just either side sticks or
center stick. It would be too bulky in here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But just, getting this down out of the way is kind of nice to see over the nose when you're doing it. Go right around. And see how easy it is when you're going fast to climb, 600 feet a minute? That's okay, because that's the way it is. I'll probably trip wrong. I just want you to feel that. It's just an airplane in the air.
It is, it's
whether
so weird.
Whether it's a Baron, whether it's a Cessna, it's still an airplane. And I love the Baron, or any Bonanzas for that matter. They land nice and easy. I always appreciated landing the Bonanzas, not necessarily the Baron, but the Bonanzas. I only flew a V-tail Bonanza, and I think it was an A36, one time. And I asked the guy, shouldn't I get checked out? And he goes, no, you fly the Quickie, that little Q2 I have in there. That's 186 knots, true. Let's do a quick turn.
Oh, geez.
This is what I call about a quick turnaround. You don't mind this stuff, do you?
No, go ahead. You're all good.
You gotta trust me. It's what I call a quick turnaround. So we'll pull it up like this, pull it over this way. I call it a quick turnaround. So we just get turned around here pretty quick, going the other way. Over the top.
You do aerobatics?
You can't, but...
No, I mean, just you, like, in general, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I'll do it, but not... On these airplanes, only rolls. So you can crank it around if you want. Pull some here, we come around here quick. See, I think the other turn's faster, coming over the top. Yeah, power's coming back. There's our target. Guns loaded. GU-11's down there.
Whee! So it's funny because this is actually only the second single engine I've ever been in.
You're kidding me.
Over 3 years.
Oh.
Yeah, so it that's why it's so different to me because the Baron's so heavy.
Yep.
That like can't do these nimble things with it, and I'm like, that's what I'm trying to grasp and absorb is just what else you can
how
do.
How light they are.
Yeah.
Well, in the smaller version of this, talk about fun. That one will roll nicely, it's quicker, it's more nimble. And this feels nimble to you because you're
right.
The Baron. Okay, there we are, the bumps again. So you see the wings move around. Hopefully that camera gets a look at the wings moving around. So we feel it in here, but not as much as we would if those wings didn't move.
I can see it flexing.
Yep. Sebastian traffic, is Bravo 916 Tango Charlie's left wide left base runway 10, Sebastian.
You call this wide, that's cute.
Yeah, this is really wide. And when I fly the twin, it's out over the road out there. Now, you can do a really close in on the twin, so when you get back up here, when the twin's gone again, it's just amazing how close in I can be and still, get down. Because these are so different. And a little bit of throttle, all of a sudden you're 10 knots fast. Nothing like a twin. With two big speed brakes out front.
So the V-twin excites me. The turbine version of the Velocity really excites me. But this bad boy, I don't know, I'm kind of waiting to see when this one is done. This is the first six-seater V-twin Velocity.
Kind of kicking the rudder around. A little bit of air there, okay, that's good. Power's coming back. There we go. again, you land once and you land again when you put the nose down. Dunk. On the brakes. Okay, just watch out for the TIP to get below 1,000. But certainly no matter off.
There is way too much for me to show you in one video. It would take a whole series of videos, and even then, I don't know that I can show you everything. So if you want to learn more about Velocity aircraft, you can stop by Sebastian Airport and take a tour of the facility yourself, even go on a demo flight, or simply just go to velocityaircraft.com to learn more.